We couldn't ask for a busier day here in Almaty, Kazakhstan. The competition at the 2017 Winter Universiade continues to get fiercer by the day. Welcome to day six. Curling action between Russia and Sweden will kick off today's highlights. Next, we'll stay on the ice but move over to Halyk Arena to see the results from China versus Sweden men's hockey. Speed skating is up next with the women's 5,000-meter event, followed by women's biathlon, 10-kilometer sprint, and, to end it off, women's alpine skiing giant slalom. Welcome now to Almaty Arena for the curling match between Sweden and Russia, who are both sitting in third place right now with 3 wins and 2 losses each. Team Russia previously beat Great Britain, Norway, and Kazakhstan and fell to Korea and Canada. Sweden took victories over China, Germany, and Korea and lost to Canada and Switzerland. These two teams now would battle it out for the better preliminary record. The first end would finish in a draw, so let's fast forward quickly to the second end where the action officially gets kicked off. Here's Russia's Victoria Moiseva letting go the last rock of the second end. You can see here, bounces off a couple. Those ones are all out, but Russia is left with one rock still in the button here. Sweden's last turn now. Big props to some vigorous sweeping there. It gets just a tad bit closer than the Russian rock. They're gonna end the second, 1-0 Sweden. They're up again here, going fast and furious right down to the button. Knocks one of Russia's out. Russia still has two in there as they go for their last throw. Sweden has no rocks in the button, so Russia just needs to land it to pick up 3 points. Now they take the lead 3-1. Moiseva throws the last rock of the fourth end now. Looking to knock out Sweden's, and they do it. Sweden with the comeback now. Here's Isabella Rana. Just need to get it closer to that center than that red rock you see on the right, and they do it. Sweden picks up one more point. It's their turn once again. Here's Isabella Rana releasing that last rock for this yellow and blue team. This one will be just short as Russia's Moiseva throws her last rock of the end. The Swedish team now takes to the sweeping. They get it a little bit further than their rock. That's right in the middle there. They pick up one more point, tying it now 3-3 heading into the seventh. Sweden's final throw here in the seventh end. They're gonna look to knock out Russian's button right in the middle of the target here. They do that, knocking out their own as well. Russia's just kind of on the cusp there at the end. Here's Moiseva, the last throw. This one, obviously good. 1 point is good, but they're gonna get the judges to measure, see if this other stone here is in that 12 foot. It is. Russia picks up 2 more points. Moiseva kicks off the eighth end now. They knock out the Sweden rock. That one's gonna be closest. 2 for each team in here as Rana throws the last rock for her team here in the eighth end. Russia will get that sweeping going. It'll be good enough and they'll pick up 1 more point now. Russia leads the way 6-3 over Sweden. In the ninth, Sweden will make a little bit of a comeback. This one's coming hot and heavy, knocks out that red stone from Russia. They get 1 more point. It's now 6-4. In the last end here, Sweden is gonna need 2 points to tie it up with Russia. Here's their last throw. It lands just in that 8-foot ring. You can see they've got two there, but Russia's Moiseeva, she's got a chance to knock them both out. The most important throw of the game. That will do it. Sweden will pick up one, but it won't be good enough. Russia takes this one 6-5 over that Swedish team. Russia now moves to a 4-2 record in this Universiade. Sweden back to a 2-4. Just to recap, it was close all the way, and in 10 ends, Russia is going to take this one 6-5. Over to Halleck Arena now for a men's ice hockey matchup between Sweden and the People's Republic of China. Heading into this one, Sweden is 0-2. So is China. Neither team has gotten a win yet here at the 2017 Winter Universiade. Let's start now by looking at the starting lineup for this Chinese team, as well as their coach, Ben Yu Wang. Here's Sweden's starting lineup, and once again, their coach, Per-Göran Tarnlund. After going scoreless in Sweden's first two games, they were hungry for a win on this one, and they had an absolutely dominating game against China. Here's Daniel Peterson of Sweden. Chucks one in from right in front of the crease. That would be Sweden's first goal of the tournament and the first goal here tonight against China. Sweden now leads 1-0. Later in the first, Peterson was at it again. A similar move here scores another one for him. Make that 2-0 now, Sweden. Both scored by Daniel Peterson. Now Sweden's Oscar Eriksson, he wanted in on the action. Great pass there by his teammate. He's able to just wrap it around the goalie there, and that one's good for another one for Sweden. China's GS Sitang Wu attempts one there, but the Swedish goalie saying, not this time. That's going to be the end of the first period. To recap, after this first, Sweden leads the way over the People's Republic of China 5-0. Let's head in now to second period action. A little bit of deja vu here. Daniel Peterson comes down the exact same move as the last two. He will get his hat trick with just 15 seconds into the second period. Take another look at this one. Around the goalie, just to the right-hand side of the net. Moving on. Sweden now on the power play. Justus Saldin just knocks in a rebound. That's going to be another one for Sweden. 7-0. Now they lead the way over China. Peng Huang trying to make something happen for this Chinese team. Gets it into the corner here. Chucks it out. His teammates pick this one up. And eventually they will get a shot on net. Take a look at this one. Just into the corner now as Swedish goalie Joko Moritz picks it up. To end the second period, this is one goal you do not want to miss. Watch this. Gustav Werneman gets it up. Shoots it against the goalie. It bounces right off, and a baseball swing by Ludwig Lundberg scores the 11th goal, shorthanded now for Sweden. The play is being reviewed. Heading into the third period now, Sweden leads 11-0 over the People's Republic of China, but they would not be done yet. Andre Gronos puts one in. Right in front of the net, you can see there. The Swedish fans quite happy with that one. Take another look. Great pass there, and just as the goalie goes down, Gronos able to chuck that one right over top. 2 minutes now left in the game. Sweden on a power play. Oscar Eriksson would join the hat trick club as he gets his third goal of the game. Let's take another look at it here in slow motion. Brings it back, slings it up right over the left shoulder of Jiankun Wu. Sweden, they're going to take that one with a score of 15-0 over China. They grab their first win with 65 shots on net compared to China's just 6. Sweden moves to 1-2 in the tournament. over to Meadow High Mountain Ice Rink now to see the women's 5,000 meter speed skating race, where three athletes will walk away with medals. 15 student athletes from 10 different countries raced for that top spot. Up first, you can see Marina Zuyeva. She's in the green on that outer ring. She's from Belarus. She's racing now against Nene Sakai from Japan. Keep in mind, once again, these two athletes not necessarily racing against each other, but racing against the clock as they take that first stretch in this race here. 7 laps to go. Marina Zuyeva takes a quick lead. You can see she's a little bit ahead right now of Sakai. Zuyeva continuing her dominance here with just 4 laps to go. Her time just over 5 minutes. Zuyeva here looks like she's all alone on this track. She's gonna win this one by more than 15 seconds. Just over 7 minutes now into this race. She will end with a time of 7 minutes, 20.11 seconds. Check out her last stretch of the race here. You can see now how far back that Japanese athlete is from her. Zuyeva will take the gold in this 5,000 meter event with a time of 7 minutes, 20.11 seconds. Here's Sakai now making her way to the end. It looks like she's very, very far behind, but she also does super well in this event. She'll pick up the silver with a time of 7 minutes, 35.14 seconds. Next up now is Korea's Jungsu Lim. She's gonna take on Anastasia Zuyeva from Russia. Zuyeva, she's on that inside ring. She's wearing blue and white. You're looking now at Lim from Korea in the black in the outside ring. ...200 meters into the race. Korea's Jungsu Lim on pace to medal in this one. Now 9 laps to go, just over 2 minutes. Remember, the gold and silver medalists ended in 7 minutes and 30-ish seconds for both of them. So now we're 5 minutes into the race. 4 laps to go here as Korea's Jungsu Lim continues her speedy race. Nearing the end of the race here, a nice push by Lim right at the end. She will end with a time of 7 minutes and 49.09 seconds. You can see her now coming close to the finish line. That time will be good enough for the bronze medal, and the Korean National Sport University student picks up her first medal at the 2017 Winter Universiad. The medals were awarded right after this event. This is the second medal now for Marina Zuyeva of Belarus. There you can see her here. She got that gold medal in the 3,000 meter sprint on February 1st. Ladies speed skating will continue tomorrow as the 1,000 meter race kicks off. The Alito Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex featured competition on the women's side today as the medaling race for the 10-kilometer pursuit got underway. Here's the list now of the first 10 athletes and their starting times. Kazakhstan's Galina Vishnevskaya, she would get off first. You can see her now making her way through the course. Again, this is one of those events that you aren't necessarily racing the person next to you, but going for the best time. So back to the starting position. 23 seconds later, it was the Ukraine's Yana Bonder's time to get started. Let's check up again on Galina Vishnevskaya of Kazakhstan as she approaches her first shooting target. Here she is now. The first one will be in the prone position as she gets ready to knock down the 5 targets. Vishnevskaya goes 5-for-5. No penalties. Beside her is Yana Bodere. Moving on now, a couple other girls have started in this race. They continue on. Here's number 5, Russia's Larissa Kuklina. And now back over to Vishnevskaya. She misses all 5 targets on her second shooting. Let's look at some other shooting now between some of the Ukraine athletes and the Kazakhstan athletes. Here's the Ukraine's Nadia Bilkina. She won the bronze in the 15-kilometer pursuit on January 31st, and she would look to continue, bring home some more medals. Here she is, Bilkina, 18 minutes into the race. Really fighting her fatigue here as she battles to get up this hill. Just under 8.5 now minutes into it. She approaches her third shooting. This one will be from a standing position. Bilkina only getting 3 of the 5 here. She misses 2 of them. Just under 20 minutes now into the race. Bondaire misses just 1 target there. She continues on. She will end up in 4th place in this race with a time of 33 minutes, 27.8 seconds. Here she is coming down a hill. You can tell that she is one of the top contenders in this one as she goes real fast. But for now, let's catch back up with the Ukraine's Nadia Bilkina. Here's her 4th shooting. She will get all but 1 as she continues on. And she will finish this one with a time of 32 minutes, 39.6 seconds. You can tell she's very happy with that one. She will finish almost 40 seconds before the silver medalist. That athlete now coming down, that's Russia's Olga Chesterikova. She finishes 33 minutes flat, 33.007. That's good for the silver medal. Last but not least in these medal tables is Russia's Larissa Kuklina. She gets the bronze. You can see how dominant Belkina's time was there. She grabs the gold medal. This is her 2nd medal now at these universities. Again, she won the bronze in the 15-kilometer pursuit on January 31st. Last but absolutely not least is alpine skiing at Shumbulak Ski Resort. We will see the ladies' giant slalom run 1 and 2, but for now, let's start with run 1. Up first here is Slovakia's Desiree Eilich as she gets ready to hit the slopes. Fast forward now to the end of the race, just over a minute in. As she makes these quick corners, you can see she's going to end with a great time. Approaching the finish line here, she will end with a time of 1 minute 15.3 seconds. Up next is Belarus's Maria Shkinova. Gotta recognize this bright orange helmet. She won the silver medal just a few days ago in alpine combined. Here she is now coming into this final stretch of this race. She will end with a time of 1 minute 16.09 seconds. Lastly, we'll watch Japan's Aso Ando take to the hill. Again, you'll recognize her. She won the silver in the ladies' Super G on January 30th. Let's watch her now finish off this race. At the finish line here, she finishes with a time of 1 minute 15.98 seconds. You can see the standings there after the first run. Now on to the second, Aso Ando, right back up. Here she goes. Great turns here by this Japanese athlete. She will finish with a time of 2 minutes and 25.68 seconds. Extremely fast for this race. Next up down the course is Slovakia's Desiree Ilek. Here she goes. She will end with quite an impressive time, but it won't be good enough to catch up with Japan's Aso Ando of 2 minutes and 25.68 seconds. Let's watch here as Ilek approaches the end of the race. Just over 2 minutes, taking those turns nice and tight. She's gonna come to the finish line shortly. Here she is. You can see her time compared to Aso Ando, who's waiting patiently at the bottom to see. It is over by 1.13 seconds. Lastly, Shkinova, she gets going. Can't miss her from any point in the race. Gotta love that orange helmet. Now moving forward, 1:25 into this race. Watch as she takes these final couple steps into it and the final stretch here. She gets close enough, 2 minutes, 15 seconds into it. You can see the final stretch now. Coming past the finish line, she will end with a time of 2 minutes, 27.28 seconds. That will be good enough for the bronze medal. All the athletes now receive their medals shortly after the race. Aso Ando happy with this one, her first gold medal at the 2017 Winter Universiad. The other girls joined her as well. Again, the Japanese athlete taking the gold, Slovakia with the silver, and Belarus will earn the bronze medal in this event.